if there is anything that COVID taught us, it's that some professions need to be treated with respect. And respect doesn't mean applauding them on social media. But, oh, kudos. Kudos, tabula mater. These people need to feed their families. Uganda, while you are to Loga, sincerely. Intern doctors in this country are striking because they are being paid 750,000 Ugandan shillings. Now that money looks a lot. So if you say they are paying us 750K, Simanya is too little, it might look like mwekuza, because in other currencies it's a lot of money actually. But if you want to see that it's very little money, convert it to dollars and see. And I think we shall have, let me see, $200, two $100 notes. So,
Tumwenyamu, naenge songa eri very serious.
Doctors in Uganda are being paid two $100 notes for working 36 hours a week. And these guys, by the way, they do all the work. It means that an intern doctor cannot kusimbula. Because kusimbula, you need Baba Sasulamo Blue Label. Actually, it's not Blue Label, because Blue Label is 1.2. So they are paying them half a bottle of Blue Label. Mukama katonda. Nurses in Canada, on the other hand, were rioting. Same things, that they were paying them too much. They wanted their salary to be reduced and things like that. And these are degree nurses, by the way. It's not like they have PhD or masters. It is the same level. Ah. Now, at the same time nurses were rioting, our doctors here in Uganda were also striking, but it's different reasons. The other ones wanted an increased salary. Here, you know the thing, it is the same drill. So this is not the first time this is happening. It has been happening, and it will surely continue to happen, because this is what the permanent secretary had to say about it.
If you really value your profession, you will come back here, finish your month, 4 months, finish. The next batch, if they are lucky, by then, if we have got that money, we shall.
Anya Tuluga. Now, the last time doctors threatened to strike, they promised to bring in Chuban doctors to come and do their work. So it's like they were disposable, not of any use. But again, things changed. Salaries were increased. People were happy, but also taxes were increased. So in the end, after all expenditures, after all taxes, you realize that bakonge dem mitwale tano joka. Literally nothing. I think rioting is the only way Ugandans can communicate to their government. Yeah, dialogue cannot work for us. And Tade boys know this concept from way back in school. You want a function, you riot, they give you the function. You come to Makerere, they increase tuition, you riot. They tear gas you, they still increase the tuition, but you have rioted, so the message has been sent. You finished, you're unemployed now, you don't have jobs, unemployed people cannot riot. Unemployed people need the government more than it needs them. Those ones are humble, they cannot riot. But, you get the job now. So now you're a government employee. And I have a feeling after the interns rioting, there's going to be another set of employees that are going to come up, because you know the circus in the country. Lecturers are about to come out that they haven't paid us for like 3 months. That is okay, we have seen this before. Then the teachers will come out. They promised them over how many billions in COVID. I don't know if they received it. God wish them. And then after the teachers, the lecturers come back, doctors come. It is a circus. It is like this. I think when the Bible said that whoever has shall be added more, the MPs in Uganda took it very seriously, because our Nath is someone who is getting 25 million a month with all those allowances, getting 200 million in car allowances. I don't know, 200 million to buy cars. Sincerely, when doctors are being paid. Kali! If there is anything that COVID taught us, it's that some professions need to be treated with respect. By respect, I don't mean applauding them on social media. Then you get up on Twitter and you're like, oh, kudos, our doctors, national heroes. Ebyo tebigula matanamwe. And mubasasule. And then I hear some people coming and they're saying, Busimanya, the government promised to increase their salaries, let them be patient, blah, blah. Promised? In Uganda? In Uganda, if someone promises you something, then I want to give it to you. Because they promised us that at the end of 2020, every Ugandan will be receiving 3 million a month. What happened after 2020? Every Ugandan is in debt of 1.5. That is how promises work in this country. It is reverse. Kugamba, if they promise them that at the end of 2 months you'll be paid 1.5 million, the 2 months might end and you're being paid 500K, even less than what we started out. That is how things work in this country. They told us in 2018 that the whole of Kampala will have a very fast and affordable Wi-Fi. What happened? Data prices increased. They bought Maiji. Maiji is now for paying, by the way. See, we have waited. Promise, in this country, they promise you something and you wait. So why are these people rioting anyway? The average intern in Uganda makes about 750,000. That's if you are lucky to get a job, because that is another hassle of its own. But if you get a job, you're going to be paid that amount. And it's not like you're working 2 or 3 days a week. These people work, by the way. They do like most of the work on those wards. And they are like the doctors you find at ward. So you work like for 36 hours a week, minimum, if you have not been overworked. Bakulanga bulogo inera wovu sende sincerely. Aba nambasa sule.